It may not look very friendly at all, but this is U.S.-Cuban diplomacy in action. That nine amateur boxers from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, were able to fight in Cuba was further proof of the thawing relations between the U.S. and the communist-run island. A two-year-old change in U.S. policy allows athletes competing on the island to skirt the American travel ban on Cuba. For the American boxers, all in their teens and early 20s, it was the chance to face seasoned opponents.
They're probably the toughest fighters in the world. You're not going to get anything like them in the ring. Training-wise is phenomenal.
Cuba may be just 90 miles from Florida, but for the U.S. boxers, it seemed a world away.
They didn't know what to expect, and they're just saying how great this trip is. They're impressed with the people. They're impressed with the architecture of the buildings. They're impressed with the weather. They're just all around impressed with everything.
This was the second boxing tournament between the U.S. and Cuba. In 2016, American fighters faced the Cubans on their home turf in Pittsburgh, losing 4-7. The fights, organizers say, are meant to unite athletes from two countries long divided by politics, but which share a common passion for boxing.
Since the thaw in relations, it's become far easier for the U.S. and Cuba to cooperate on exchanges like this one. But President Trump has promised to take a tougher stance on Cuba, and many here now worry that activities designed to bring the two countries together will once again become a thing of the past.
Cuban officials say despite the many differences between the U.S. and Cuban governments, there should continue to be exchanges, and that Cuba hopes to host, for the first time, professional boxers from the U.S. We are studying the possibility of having a match, Cuba's top boxing official says, between the leading U.S. professional boxers and our Olympic world champion.
Head body, head body, head body!
Even though the 1959 revolution banned professional sports, Cuba has remained a boxing powerhouse. While the Cubans swept this tournament 6-3, for the Americans who beat heavily favored opponents, victory was sweet.
Yeah, I was nervous. We were supposed to all get beat up, but I proved that wrong.
But in the end, both sides said, success wasn't based on jabs or knockouts, but on bringing young athletes from very different places together. Patrick Oppmann, CNN, Pinar del Rio, Cuba.